and coming in, Lord, you grant her joy and mercy.
Amen.
Have long life for us, O Lord.
Amen.
That you give her your strength, for in Jesus' name I've prayed.
Amen.
By the goodness of the Lord upon our mother, especially our mommy, she teaches us how to know our left and right. She teaches us the word of God.
Mommy taught me how to read, and she taught me how to take my bath, and she taught me how to pray. I wish her long life.
That Jesus rode on a donkey and came into Jerusalem to be killed for the sins of the people. The sins of the people of this place will be dealt with in Jesus' name. He who sacrificed himself and accepted to die for all of us. Jesus is welcomed in Nyango, Chen Nyango, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Good afternoon. My name is Patience Blue Squashy. I'm a graduate of Zambri School, and I'm here to give a report on Zambri mission work. Zambri School is born out of the burden of the experience and participation of its president, Dr. Mrs. Gloria Ladi Kwashi. Before Zambri came into existence, the community knew less about God and education. Many children were not able to read and write, and many are orphans who cannot afford to go to school. Children, adults, and youth live a carefree life, many of them not knowing their rights and responsibilities. But when Zambri came into existence 10 years back, children, youth, and orphans were enrolled into Zambri in order to be able to read and write. Not only that, but also know God and His Son, Jesus Christ, who gave us salvation. Zambri Mission Work has helped its students and the community in their spiritual lives. Many children now know Christ and know the importance of education as well. When the mission work at Zambri started, the school faced many challenges by the community, some of them threatening to destroy and to demolish the school. But through all the problems and challenges, Zambri never gave up hope, and that inspiring hope is what Zambri is today. Zambri, which connotes life is not an accident, has become a place of refuge for many orphans and vulnerable children like us. Zambri in itself is like a home for all of us because most of our activities are done there. Zambri has rendered a lot of love, care, and kindness to the community by teaching them to be selfless, godly, honest, self-controlled, patriotic, and loving. Zambri comprises of two church, which are the St. Athanasius Chapel for the students and the Majamia Al-Masihu for new beginners in Christ. Zambri students are encouraged to always attend discipleship class and choir, which help them in their spiritual life. Zambri has indeed offered us with the basic foundation, which is the knowledge of God. We have learned to be hardworking because nothing good comes easy. We are taught to be loving, respectful, polite, and to live godly lives. By God's grace, throughout the corona pandemic period, we have been having our services at home, which is on Facebook and also WhatsApp. This has greatly contributed in the expansion of the mission in Zambri. Many people, both locally and internationally, watch and view our Sunday services at Gideon Kona, led by His Grace, Most Reverend Dr. Benjamin Argo Kwashi, our father. The mission in Zambri has helped in shaping the lives of the students, most especially the community youth and children. Before now,
If a child is proved to be stubborn, the community people will conclude that that child is in association with either a secret society or cult groups. Thankfully to God, the mission and hard work of Zambri has been able to correct that mentality by teaching the people the way of God and how to raise and correct their children in the Lord. It is always the joy of Zambri mission workers to see that people are saved from this sinful world and to see that people are educated. The Anglican Bishop of Jos has also dedicated his time and effort during the corona pandemic lockdown to teach students and children at home in the areas of English language. He has also promised to continue teaching English at Zambri when schools reopened. Knowing God, education and hygiene are the key aims of Zambri School. Education has really broadened our horizon and capacity to read, write and pass examinations like WAEC and NECO. In Jam, the first set of graduating students, set 219, has a high score of 208 and the lowest 138. The first set of graduates were 9 in number, 7 by the grace of God got admission into the university at Cotonou of Benin Republic. 2 are currently at Christian Institute, dedicating their life to the work of God. Zambri mission work also includes the invitation of the community to their occasional cinema of godly movies from which lessons are learned and applied. The annual Christmas by the book End of the Year Christmas Party has great effect on the community and its dwellers. We use this media to invite them to Christ and we use it to teach them about the birth and life of Jesus Christ before his death and resurrection. Our profound gratitude goes to God for inspiring the vision and mission of Zambri School into the heart of its president, Dr. Mrs. Gloria Ladi Kwashi, supported by her husband, family, friends, both local and international.
Peter Daliok, I baptize in the name of the Father,
Amen.
And of the Son,
Amen.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We receive Peter Mancha Daliok into the congregation of Christ's flock, and we do sign him with the sign of the cross, in token that hereafter he shall not be ashamed to profess the faith of Christ crucified, and to continue Christ's soldier, faithful servant, unto his life's end. Justin Cho, I baptize you in the name of the Father,
Amen.
And of the Son,
Amen.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We receive Justin Cho into the congregation of Christ's flock, and do sign with the sign of the cross, token that hereafter he shall not be ashamed to profess the faith of Christ crucified, and manfully fight against the devil, against the world, the flesh, and the devil, and to continue Christ's faithful soldier and servant unto his life's end.
Amen. Amen.